All right, let's do this.
In the previous episode of Life is Strange.
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
No!
He called film little pieces
of
time.
What the fuck?
But he could be talking about photography.
Or have you done something wrong? Talk to me.
Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
Hey, leave him alone! Max? Chloe?
It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Welcome home, Max.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
6 months ago, she just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me. Something happened to her.
Wait! Is that grass? Tell me the truth. That's an order.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Max, tell me everything.
Choose wisely.
Being a superhero is dirty work. I need a shower.
All right.
Okay, Max, let's hit the showers now. Mrs. Hoyda is still out sick. I heard somebody say she has severe depression. Poor thing.
You ready then? That's what we got in this room right now.
Do not forget I need those papers before tonight. Like now. Thanks, Sherry.
Yeah, of course, Victoria. I'll get the tests and papers to you this afternoon. I am so on it, considered it done.
Yay! No. Sure, why not? Let's knock on it.
Fine, I won't disturb you.
Come on! Open the door! Do it!
Fine, I won't disturb you.
All right, fine. Be that way.
Fine, I won't disturb you.
Kate!
Kate is an early bird. She might be up and gone.
You didn't. Leave your mum
You okay, Alyssa?
Immature assholes. Sorry, Max. I'm not feeling social right now.
Alright, then. Always be aware of your location. Always let a friend know where you are and where you're going. Always reporting that, blah, blah.
It'll be fun. Glad I'm not the only lonely nerd around here.
You girl book club, eh? No boy wizard or sad vampire fiction allowed.
Thanks for the warning.
Coming soon. Whatever. Before we shower, let's go check out these other room.
I didn't think Kate was like
this.
Chloe is so determined to find you, Rachel.
Hey, how are you doing?
What's happening, Dana? Everything cool between you and Juliet?
Oh, yeah. Thanks again for releasing me from her captivity. By the way, the best and biggest news of the day is that Trevor asked me to the Halloween shindig.
That's awesome, Dana.
At least we're showing our faces together in public. So you absolutely should go with us. Borrow one of my outfits and come as a cute geek couple with your bitch, Warren.
What?
I'm not big on cosplay.
Don't let life pass you by, Max. So, are you coming to the party or not?
Sure, why not?
Why the fuck not? If I hate it, I can always go back to my room.
That's the spirit, Max. After this, you'll be ready for a rave.
It does sound like fun. Now I have to go contemplate my party future.
Check something here. Cool. Resume. All right. What else can we do here? Juliet, speak
Hello,
to me.
Hello, Juliet.
Hey, Max. Did you check out Kate's hot video yet?
What? Why?
Why should I?
Because it's fucking hilarious. Church girl gone wild.
Kate's not like that, and you know it.
Really? Check her out and tell me what she's like.
Do you believe everything you see? Like Zachary sexting Dana?
Touché. Now I feel like an ass.
Better.
Thanks for finding out the truth yesterday.
What about Zachary?
What about Zachary? Did you let him off the hook?
When he acts like a worm, I let him dangle.
Glad to see you're back in action.
You have a good heart, Max. And I won't watch Kate's video anymore. Or pass it on.
That's the spirit. Thanks, Juliet.
Sure. Talk to you later.
Hey, Burr. What are you gonna say?
Hey, Brooke.
Oh, hi, Max.
Seems no. You look distracted.
You look distracted. Everything cool?
I was riveted by that weird snow flurry yesterday.
I can't tell if you're being serious or not. Since I'm a science noob, I was wondering if you could explain it.
I'm serious. Even meteorologists can't explain that snow. I bet Warren can. Did you talk to him yet?
No. No, I'm not.
No, not at all. He's my friend, not my mother.
True. And Warren really loves to talk meteorology with me, since I'm one of the few who can talk back. Talk to you later, Max.
All right, then. Doot-doot-doot. Knocky-knock.
Taylor is no doubt being led around by Victoria, as usual.
Room service. What does that say? Get a life and move on, bit. Oh. Alrighty then. Hello?
Go away! People sleeping!
Ugh.
Clearly not a morning person.
People sleeping or people are sleeping?
Go away! People sleeping!
Okay.
Clearly not a morning person.
So tired, you can't talk right. Oh, yay.
Hey, Kate. Sorry about yesterday.
Yeah, I'm sorry you didn't do anything to help. But you're just like everybody else here.
Why?
It's not true. I wanted to help, but...
Whatever. It's done. By the way, Max, do you still have my copy of the October Country?
Oh, yes, of course. It's sure. Great so far. I didn't realize Bradbury was such a poet.
Can you please bring it back to my room this morning? I just need to take some notes for class.
Absolutely. I'll bring it by later.
Hey, March Horse. No? What else we in here? Tampon dispenser. Alright, well, whatever. Shower, I guess. You get a shower in your clothes. Ah, there we go. When's the prank gonna happen? Something's gonna happen.
What's up, Kate?
School. That's it?
That video of you clubbing didn't look like homework.
Why?
Victoria, that wasn't me.
Oh my god, right.
Oh my god.
Don't be shy. I think it's awesome you set a tongue record on video.
You're going to be sorry someday.
Oh, boy.
Oh, boo-hoo. I'm sorry you're a viral slut. I'm sure she had fun.
Looks like it.
I know Nathan hooked her up. And you know he has the good shit.
Preach it, sister.
Yup, I still have goddamn paint all over my face. Good thing my faithful minions took their sweet time bringing me a towel.
We ran all the way.
Give it a rest, Taylor. Now I know if I'm in an accident, I won't rely on you or Courtney for help. You can hang out with Kate or Max.
What? Frick you. What a bitch.
She's a weirdo with that dumb camera.
I hate that I'm so quirky crap. Anyway. Let's leave the link to Kate's video so everybody gets a chance to see her in action.
No. You're such an evil biatch. I love it.
Pretty short URL. Time to clean that biatch.
I better get dressed and go give back Kate's book.
And erase that.
Even if I can stop one person from watching it, it's worth it.
Hello? Water?
Sorry. I forgot.
Trust no one. Shampoo bottle. This.
The last time I got a flu shot, I got the flu. Fuck you.
It's been years since I got mine. Rachel is a whore. Okay. Good to know. Ah, what's going on in here now?
Excuse me, I'm texting Zach.
Are you now? Okay.
Let's talk later, Max.
Leave your door open then.
Really, Max?
What? Fine, I'll get changed. Dressed.
Maybe I'll just put on a shirt and jeans.
Hey, Einstein had the same exact suit for every day of the week, and he couldn't even rewind time.
I wonder if he actually did that. Alright, what now? Guess we'll just leave the dorm.
Hold up, I need to find the book before going to see Kate.
Ah, yes. Good call. Search.
My desk is a pigsty, but I know it ain't there.
That's not too bad, I guess. It's just on the floor.
And nothing here.
Lost it, didn't you?
No book here.
Did you put it?
My desk is a pigsty.
Yeah, we already seen that.
I know it ain't there.
Oh no. It was bad real life. Can't find nothing. Research that. Let's search this.
Of course she just spilled soda on Kate's book. Better fix this fast. Kate needs the book, and I don't want to add to her list of problems.
It says move the glass first.
Get be gone, there. Foul soft drink.
Alright. Take the book. Take it, yes.
Aha, you sneaky book. You're mine.
Kind of abusive power.
Now I can
finally
take this back to Kate before I'm late. As if I have to worry about being late anymore. I do have all the time in the world now.
Oh boy. Private number. Brooke, hello.
No Brooke here.
This is private number. Keep your smart mouth shut about everything, or I'm coming for your ass. I know where you sleep. I wonder who that is. You are evil. 40 minutes or else. What? What?
Even with all this crazy shit going on, it is so cool having Chloe back in my life again. Like no time has passed.
Hey there. Alright.
Kate? You in there?
Yes, I'm here. Come in, Max.
You play the violin, eh?
Kate used to play the violin every morning. She stopped last week.
What? Why?
Kate even makes notes in her Bible. My parents never once took me to church. I had nothing to rebel against. I don't know what to believe now.
Photo, what's that?
Damn, it's the all-American zombie family. It's way too emo in here. Kate isn't that gloomy. Until lately.
She's being bullied, so I guess that makes sense.
Poor Kate. She doesn't look good. Hey, Kate, I brought your book.
Max, why didn't you do anything when David harassed me yesterday?
I did. I took a picture. I had a picture.
I wanted proof David was in your face.
I thought he was different. I'm happy to see that somebody cares.
Kate, I actually do care. So, what's the story with you and David?
Well, he's a total paranoid ass.
Yeah, that's true.
He thinks I'm part of the Vortex Club.
What?
Yeah, right.
Why?
Why does he think that?
Because he saw the video.
Video.
You know how humiliating this is for me?
I know this sucks, Kate, but tell me about the video and maybe I can help.
Basically, I went to one Vortex Club party and ended up making out with a bunch of people. And I have no memory of it.
That's awful.
Drugged?
So, how did that happen?
It's a long story. I'm still trying to sort it all out.
You have to tell me more than that. What happened at the party? Did you drink?
I swear to God, I had one sip of red wine, and then I drank water.
Not enough to get wasted, sure.
Not enough to get wasted, is it?
I don't get wasted. Ever. I take a sip at church, and I don't end up on a viral video, okay?
Did somebody drug you?
I remember.
Yeah,
I remember
someone
getting
did.
Sick and dizzy.
Go on.
Then Nathan Prescott said he would take me to the hospital.
Not that dick.
Nathan Prescott? Oh, shit.
He was being nice for a change when he offered to help me.
He's the opposite of nice. What next?
All I recall is driving for a long time. Then I woke up in a room. I thought it was a hospital because it was so white and bright.
Go on. I'm listening.
Somebody was talking to me in a soft voice. I thought it was a doctor until I heard Nathan and felt a sharp sting in my neck.
And?
That's all I remember. I don't know what happened. I woke up outside my dorm room the next day. I didn't have any marks or bruises, but I felt gross.
So, who took the video of you at the party?
I have no idea. Probably Victoria. She was there being her mean self.
Jesus, Kate. I'm sorry. This is serious shit.
How do I get a viral video taken down? I know it's already spreading. What if my church sees that? I need to know what to do.
Kate, we'll figure it out. I'll check back later, okay?
Read the book, too.
Thanks, Max. You can put my book here near my bag.
Ouch. She left out damnation. Jesus, this is intense. If Kate wasn't out of it and is actually telling the truth... Kate's art is perfect for a children's book. Everything looks so fun and colorful and positive.
I am, though.
Why did she cover up the mirror? She can't look at herself?
Oh, boy. Why can't I leave? She postcards.
Kate really has a doting father.
Light shines in darkness, and the darkness compends. Comprehends is not. Always be my brightness. Alright, brightness in the dark, alright. Hugs and love, Pop. That's his name, Pop. Hey, it's a rabbit.
That is the cutest bunny ever. I bet Kate is a good mommy.
Let's take a picture here. She'll probably get mad. Or it'll freak out. Feel that view, eh?
Ouch. She left that animation. Screwed ordeal could...
Oh, I heard that. Alright, can I leave now?
That's a lot of tears. She's going to go through boxes.
Let's leave. Leave. Please leave. Oh, I didn't put the book away, that's why.
So, Max, can I ask you a question? And please be honest.
Absolutely, Kate. Anything.
I need to find out if Nathan Prescott helped me or hurt me after that party. Should I go to the police?
Let's look for proof first.
If you do that, they won't believe you. You're on video grabbing at all those guys, and they'll use that against you. Bad.
But I know I was drugged.
That's what you have to prove, not them. I'm just telling you how the cops in school will look at this. The video doesn't exactly back you up.
You make me feel so hopeless.
No, no, Kate. I just don't want you to get hurt anymore.
That seems impossible at this point. So that's your answer?
I think we should wait. There are other things going on that might help you.
But not right now. So I can walk down the halls with people calling me a viral slut. Thanks, Max.
Shit. Oi.
Good job, Dr. Max. She didn't like what I had to say, but we need more proof of what happened.
Sure, whatever. We'll leave it that way. I feel like she's gonna probably try killing herself, though. Max, food, two whales. See you there. You're protecting a breakfast. No emoji. What? Alright. Leave the dorm. Food. That was the bird.
The birds are flocking around Samuel.
Speak.
Hey, Samuel. You're up early.
Oh. Hello, young Max. I do love the early morning. Everything is so calm and quiet. And I can feel the animals waking up with me.
Oh.
So, what did you think about that freak snow shower yesterday?
Another message from the Earth to get our shit together. I will say that Samuel hasn't seen anything like that before.
Animals!
That's one thing I truly love about Arcadia Bay. It's all those cool animals in the forest.
The squirrels always come in the morning for food. I can hear them whisper. What animals do you see in the forest?
A doe.
Don't laugh, but I saw a doe that seemed to be looking right at me, like it was trying to communicate.
Oh, that's your spirit animal. Nothing weird there except you saw yours. Could be a sign about your destiny. What do I know? My spirit animal is a squirrel.
I so don't want to get in the way of your morning ritual. See you later.
Of course you will.
All right. Let's go check out some rooms.
The paint job looks great. Samuel knows his color schemes.
I assume so. What else we got, Hal?
I can see that Samuel's concerned, but does he need a poster? How did
Maybe.
Samuel get photos of Rachel posing? Samuel really should keep this locked. It's a waiting accident and too easy to sneak into. I definitely won't play with this thing again.
Are you sure? I see squirrels. I have to talk to him again.
Hello again, Samuel.
Hello again yourself, Max.
Rachel.
Sorry to pry, Samuel, but why are there photos of Rachel Amber in your shed? I'm curious about her.
Sorry to pry, she says while prying. Now everybody wants to know about her.
You know her?
So did you know her?
Like I told the police. She was a good egg. And she gave me those photos.
Oh, you talked to the police? Rachel wanted to be a model.
Yeah. She gave out headshots like squirrels chasing food. Keep on prying, Max. It's Sounds like you have a lot of time on your hands.
I so don't want to get in the way of your morning ritual. See you later.
Of course you will.
All right. Square up. Ah, Bugsy. Speak to
you. Hi, Taylor.
Time.
Hi, Taylor. Just because you were nice to Victoria doesn't mean I have to be nice to you.
Let's not fight.
I don't want to fight with you or Victoria. Instead of smack talk, let's just talk. For once.
You're funny. Well, I'm not doing anything at the moment, so talk.
Talk about Kate's video.
Kate is really upset about the video. All this gossip is cruel.
Boo-hoo. That's what happens when you preach to everybody about sex. She'll live.
Will she?
Why do you hang out with Victoria? She's pretty mean to you and Courtney.
And she's bossy, too. Look, you don't know her. I do. And she's one of the best friends you could have.
What's your best friend?
I guess I've had mean, bossy best friends, too. Better than having mean, bossy parents.
I would love it if my mom was mean or bossy instead of sick. But whatever. We've had our talk.
Sick, eh?
Taylor.
Conversation over.
Fine, be that way.
when they put their names on schools and libraries. Let's not get downcast. I hear the fish calling for Bali High. Never forget that old fishermen never die. We just smell that way.
I'd love to learn more, but I have to get going. Happy fishing out there.
Speak again.
I think I've talked my quota for the year.
All right, then. I go across the street. Or am I getting hit by a car? Nope. Okay. What else is out here?
Excuse me, sir?
Can you believe this town? The world is on fire, and our big headline is snow. I can hardly wait for next week's big story. Clouds!
Alrighty then. How long have you lived here?
How long have you lived here?
Long enough to know that Arcadia Bay will be a ghost town in a few years.
I keep reading how Arcadia Bay is booming.
The paper can only talk about that or about missing girls.
That is a mystery.
This town is more like a mystery to me.
You're young. You'll get over it. Excuse me. I have to read my horoscope.
That's an idea.
Nope, I don't want to go there.
All right. Anyone else? Oh, a homeless person. Hooray!
Hello.
Oh, look at you. A fine example of youth. I bet you're a senior student.
Yes, I go to Blackwell Academy.
I could tell you're a wise young woman. I know all about Blackwell and this town.
Let's ask about eBay.
How long have you lived in Arcadia Bay?
1,000 years. I've gone through the same changes as the town.
It is.
What changes to the town?
Ones it takes a lifetime to see. There's a lot of beauty here, but a lot of darkness, too. Greedy bastards that ruin this town put people out of work. Out of home. Like me.
I'm sorry. Have you ever lived outside of here?
Where the hell would I go? I hate the sun and love the mist. I might be homeless, but Arcadia Bay is still my home.
Joyce Price.
You must know Joyce Price from the Two Whales Diner.
She's fed me more than my own family. How's a daughter your age who's always in trouble? Married to a real prick.
Have you met Joyce's daughter?
Cute girl. Pissed off. I used to see her and her pretty friend, Rachel, around a lot.
Yeah, right.
Do you know anything about Rachel Amber? That missing girl?
I know she's missing. And I know she hung out here a bit. Sometimes I'd see her walking, all by herself, deep in thought. Too damn young and pretty to look so worried.
Alright.
Did you talk to her?
Once or twice she'd talk to me. About trouble in school. Wanting to be some model in California. She was always distant. But nice. I pray the poor thing is alright. But you can't save everybody.
I bet you have dirt on the Prescott family.
That whole family is dirty. They once done good things for Arcadia Bay. Those days are dead, like anything in their way.
I know somebody who's being threatened by a Prescott.
Then you be their guardian angel, because nothing gets in the way of that family, especially not the law. Hell, they own your school, Blackwell. Almost.
I have to go now. Goodbye.
Goodbye now.
Come talk to me any old time you want, young lady.
All right. What's we got back here? Dog. image stabilizer achievement. Alright, let's go in this restaurant, I suppose. Oh, you played the bar box. It might have an importance later, maybe. Who's this? I already talked to you.
Snow. Well, that's a good start to the story.
Rare emission, the National Weather Service has yet to come up with a conclusive reason for the unusual snowfall that really hit Arcadia Bay. Whatever. Alright, let's go in.
Man, that smell of breakfast and the sound of clanging silverware makes me feel 13 again.
Hey, Trevor.
Hola, Max. By the way, I know you saw me in the dorm.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw you coming out of Dana's room.
Yeah, and I finally had to tell Justin because, well, he was into her too.
How did Justin react?
I got him blazed. He was cool. Nobody has secrets in Blackwell anyway. See you in class, Max.
What's up, Justin?
Getting my coffee on before I cut class and destroy some rails. Shouldn't you be taking photos?
I am.
I am always taking photos. I am a camera.
You crack me up, Maxer. Of course I'm baked. So I'll laugh at anything.
You should be studying, bad boy.
So where's all your homework, schoolgirl?
School? Speaking of buds, I saw your bro Trevor sneaking out of Dana's room.
Trevor finally told me about him and Dana hooking up. He got there first, so I snooze and I lose. See you later, Max.
It's sport, I guess. Food.
Drool. Want everything.
I'm kinda actually hungry in real life. Damn it. Use. Cartoon. Start. Country, no.
Forgot about the fishing wall of fame.
Well, let's gotta talk to you.
Hello?
Pardon moi, but you're in my eyesight.
Isn't everything in here within eyesight?
I don't care for your tone. You sound like Joyce.
How does Joyce sound?
Bossy and smartass. Like you.
All right.
Joyce rules. I want to be exactly like her when I grow up.
Looks like you're on your way. I've been coming to this dive for 3 years, and Joyce gives me shit like it's going out of style.
That's how she rolls. That's why I worship her every move.
Good. I can't wait to see you flipping greasy bacon in a diner when you grow up. Exactly like Joyce. Now pardon me while I get back to my coffee.
All right, then.
I don't feel like talking right now.
That's right, you don't.
I gotta deliver a load of breakfast to my stomach. Over now.
Hello, sir.
Hi, young lady. You look a little lost.
Hungry.
Just hungry and thinking about what to eat.
Now, that is a real problem at the Two Wells. I can never decide. Joyce's pumpkin pie or grilled mac and cheese?
Let's ask about Chloe.
So, you know Chloe?
Sadly, we all know Chloe down at the station. Poor Joyce. Just heard that Chloe even had a pot dealer in her room.
Who told you?
Who told you that?
I didn't hear it on the police scan. Joyce said the weed belonged to Chloe's friend, but I highly doubt that.
Joyce didn't tell you who?
She wouldn't. Afraid I'd go arrest somebody, as if I would. I'd just tell the loser to stay the hell away from Chloe, or else. Just kidding. Besides, David Madsen's watching over. Is she a friend of yours?
I know her.
Then you know she's a handful.
Can't be.
She can be, but she can also be a good friend who shows up when you need her.
Sounds like you're a good friend. I wish she would be a great daughter and not cause Joyce so much stress.
That's what Joyce said.
How well do you know Joyce?
I know her delicious grub. Everybody at the station comes here. We take care of this place like it's our own kitchen. And Joyce, like she's our mother.
I guess you're friends with David Madsen.
I wouldn't use that word. We know each other. Why do you ask?
His reputation.
He kinda has a reputation at Blackwell.
I have respect for David. He served his country. He found his calling at Blackwell. At the station, we're happy David is exactly where he is. Not everybody can be a cop.
I have to go now. Enjoy your breakfast.
By the way, one thing I can tell you for certain is to stay away from that RV outside.
I usually stay away from sketchy parked vehicles.
Wise policy. The guy who lives in it, Frank, is pretty sketchy himself. That's all I can say for now. I should finish up my coffee and get to work.
You probably know something I need to know.
What do you want? I feel like shit. Too much beer, so spare me, please. Just let me suffer quietly.
Fine, be that way. Your lady, fisherman.
Did you catch any big ones today?
If by big you mean none, then sure. I caught a lot of big ones today. Now let me mourn over my eggs.
All right.
Hello there to you. Such a beautiful day, eh? Oh, yeah, it's gonna be a super day. Enjoy your breakfast, eh?
You're supposed to be Canadian? Rumble stand.
Oh, man. I bet that's the same gum from when I was here last.
Kate Marsh, love you long time. Let's see, for you.
Gross.
I am too miserable. Let's behave, what?
That graffiti has been here forever.
That's the IR.
Thank you, redneck poet.
Huh. Hey, photos. Next. Sit down here or something. Or should I go try talking to that dude? Oops. Even get there.
There's that dirty RV from the other day.
Stop that! Stop! No barking.
There was something creepy about that guy and his dog.
Guess I can't talk to him. Just go ahead and move then. Sit. Sit's boof. All right, there we go. Hey, coffee.
And there she is. A lovely young woman. How are you doing, Max?
Hi, Joyce. It's nice to see you again. You look the same.
Like I'm still a waitress at Two Whales after all these years.
No, like you still look pretty.
Nice save, kid. You're still smart. But not that smart. Now you get busted for smoking pot. I heard the whole sordid story from David. I'm sorry this was how you had to meet him. He's a good man, no matter what Chloe says.
Yeah, I'm sure. I don't even smoke, like, ever. It was almost an accident. It was very stupid. I'm sorry.
It surprised me fierce. I was hoping you could be a good influence in her life now.
I will be. Promise. I know things were hard for you and Chloe. I feel bad I didn't call. Now my folks are in Seattle and I'm all alone at Blackwell. It's my karma.
You did the right thing. You moved forward with your life. I did after William passed on. Chloe chose to stay angry. Anyway, I hope we see more of you. Chloe needs an old friend again.
Joyce, I am so sorry about William. I have great memories of him.
I'm glad, Max. That was his gift to us. Wonderful memories. Even if Chloe doesn't understand yet.
Chloe understands.
Chloe understands. She just needs time. I know that sucks for you.
Oh, she hit all the phases. Expulsion, running away, drugs, bad boys, tattoos, piercings, blue hair. Now she's got to rebel against her stepfather.
I see why, I mean.
Do you? He's not as much of a hard ass as you think. But you did tell him you had a joint, right? You took that responsibility?
I did.
And I am sorry. I don't want Chloe in any more trouble. Or me.
Nobody's in trouble over a doobie, Max. And I admire that you took the heat for Chloe. Like a great friend. But Chloe does push David, and it's not fair. He paid his dues in a war. He does care about her, along with all the students at Blackwell.
And super surveillance, he cares about Kate Marsh.
He cares about Kate Marsh?
David mentioned her, but I stay out of his business. I won't patrol Blackwell, and he won't cook at the diner, you know?
Yesterday, I took a picture of him fighting with Kate. I thought you might know why.
Nice try, Nancy Drew. But next to you, there's only one student I'm worried about. And she's not even in school anymore. So, now let's get down to the nitty-gritty. What do you want to eat?
Yes, what indeed? Belgian waffles are good.
The last good Belgian waffle I had was here when I was 13 years old. So, bring it on.
Now finish your coffee.
One Belgian waffle for the hungry girl, pronto.
The only thing that's changed on the menu are the prices.
You see how it is in a lot of old restaurants?
Waffle at 12 o'clock hot.
I love the delicious anticipation of breakfast.
Who's this? I'll just drink my coffee. Suppose.
Can I get some beer and bacon before I die?
This is like fourth dimensional deja vu. I keep going back in time.
Looks like you had plenty. Stick with bacon.
Drink.
Order ready.
This is like fourth dimensional deja vu. I keep going back in time.
What kind of dive is this?
Incoming.
Oh, look at the graffiti.
I can hear your stomach rumbling from here, Max. Here, you'll love this.
I'm drooling like a baby.
Still can't believe you're a woman. When I look at pictures of Chloe, speak of the devil.
Mom and Max, together again.
And Chloe looking for a free meal. You put your whole damn college fund on your tab.
I'm treating Chloe for breakfast.
Are you atoning for yesterday?
Oh, God, Mom, please do not give Max any shit for that. She apologized.
I know she did. Max is a good girl, but woman. She's 18 now.
Too old to get lectures from you or Sergeant Pepper.
Call him David if you don't want to be lectured. You only get one damn slice of bacon a day.
You guys are still the same.
Another reason to blow this town. What is this shit on the jukebox?
Don't do that, guys can get really mad.
Now that that's out of the way.
Let's talk about your superpower. I don't have any explanation, and I can't explain why I saw that crazy fucking tornado.
Come on, that's just a daydream. I want proof you can rewind time.
This is all happening so fast.
We'll start slow. Right here, now.
I can tell you every single thing you have in your pockets.
You have X-ray vision, dude? I don't even know what's in my pockets. Let me see. Okay, Max. Impress me.
Keys.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
Chain, razor blade, keychain, bullet keychain, bullets.
A bullet, just like your necklace.
That was so wrong, Max. Okay, psychic girl, let me show you what's actually in my pockets. That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
I see what we got.
Okay, Max. Study every item carefully and don't forget anything.
Panda bear smokes. American, it's quarter? Yeah, quarters. This is a warning ticket. Cent, 5 cents, quarter. All right. Rewind. There. Break it.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
Alright, so you got money.
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
Ah, crap. Of course it wants to know that. 86 cents?
86 cents.
That's right. Living large in Arcadia Bay. So that was cool. Show me more.
Cigarettes.
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
There's 8, or there's 7? 7.
7 cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool. Amazing. Something else in my pockets?
Parking ticket.
A parking ticket.
You know me well. But what is the exact time I was busted?
Ah, crap, I didn't remember that. 10:34.
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time! Even a broken clock is right twice a day. Whatever the hell that means.
Keys.
Your car keys.
Duh! Way too easy! I need details! Describe my keychain.
Penguin keychain.
A penguin keychain.
Do I look like a Linux nerd like your pal Warren? Okay, psychic girl. Let me show you what's actually in my pockets.
A penguin? Oh, it was a panda.
That was beyond epic fail. You even made me want to believe you.
Let's go back. Go back. Dang it. Right over here. I have to go back all the way, do I? Ew.
So, this is me telling you what's inside your pockets.
Okay, Max. I'm hella ready.
I have a parking ticket.
A parking ticket.
You know me well. But what is the exact time I was busted?
10:34.
10:34 a.m.
Booyah! Max can tell time. Even a broken clock is right twice a day. Whatever the hell that means.
Money.
Some money.
Clearly I'm rich as fuck. How much do I have?
86 cents.
86 cents.
That's right. Living large in our.
Yeah, I got right still.
So that was cool. Show me more.
You have keys.
Your car keys.
Duh, way too easy. I need details. Describe my keychain.
Excellent. That's definitely a panda.
A cute robot panda keychain.
Not bad, Super Max. You do have that Irish luck, Caulfield. What else?
Cigarettes.
I'm pretty sure you have cigarettes on you.
Yes, you know I'm a smoker. But how many cigarettes?
Seven.
Seven cigarettes.
A superpower that allows you to count cigarettes. Cool. Amazeballs. I literally just got chills all over my neck. You have powers.
I'll take that crap off the table, Chloe.
Sure, Mom.
How's the food, Max?
Better than I remembered.
Very good save.
Man, I'm hungry like the wolf.
Clearly.
Like the wolf.
I'm freaking out about what just happened. You have to show me more. Something way cooler so I will believe you without any doubt.
I will predict the future.
No way.
Now, pay attention to everything that happens in the next few moments so you can dazzle Chloe with your mad power.
Oops.
Did you break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Song
this is
yet.
Sure the hell better than that other garbage.
I think our jukebox is headed for Davy Jones's locker.
So, what are you waiting for?
Not much. Let's see if I can remember all this.
I'm going to predict four events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so.
Trucker drops his mug, I believe.
The trucker drops his mug, and Joyce rips him a new one.
So, what happens next?
Cop radio.
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, and he quickly exits the diner.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Send Trevor fight? Stops him. Joyce doesn't care. Joyce stops him.
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
I screwed up.
This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
Crap, I didn't see no butterfly.
Crazy as a butterfly lands on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens like you said.
I think I screwed that up.
Oops.
Dude,
did you
right.
break another cup? Really? No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You're a
I think
dick.
Not,
slap
Max.
Me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
That is wild.
It was a cockroach, okay. Yeah, let's do that one more time. With the scripts. I see it.
I'm going to predict four events that will happen in the next 30 seconds or so.
This drops her plate. Trevor drops his glass. Cobb drops his glass. Trucker drops his mug.
The trucker drops his mug, and Joyce rips him a new one.
So, what happens next?
Fire release.
The cop gets an emergency alert on his radio, and his partner in the car leaves without him.
Well, let's just see how this goes down.
Justin and Trevor are fighting, and Joyce breaks it up.
This is getting good. Can't wait to see what happens.
As crazy as a cockroach crawls on it. Yep.
The jukebox goes crazy as a cockroach crawls on it.
Pretty bizarro, Max. But let's see if everything happens like you said.
I'm assuming so.
Did you break another cup?
Oh, way
really?
To go, Mom.
No refill for you.
Shh. Now I gotta take this call and leave my breakfast. Hey, where is my partner?
You called him. He's off to go bust some skaters.
You're a dick.
Don't slap me, bitch. Take your fight club outside.
He started it.
I'm finishing it.
Trevor and Justin must be in love. You predicted a cockroach on the jukebox? I pledge allegiance to Max and the power for which she stands.
This
yeah, got
isn't
right.
a toy, Chloe. I do have to be careful how I use it.
Screw that! Of course it's a toy. The best toy ever? You can bang anyone with no strings attached, rewind time, and boom! It's like it never happened!
Grow up.
Maybe you made a move on me and I would never know.
Yes, that's what I did.
You can rewind time, Max. That's fucking insane. We have to play.
I don't have time.
You did not just say that. Check out your nose. Too much blow? Hey, are you okay?
Too much excitement. See what happens when we hook up again?
Then, let's go to one of my secret lairs and fully test your power. You need a sidekick to guide you.
Okay, Girl Wonder. Show me the way to Chloe's cave.
Finish. No, don't leave it. No. Okay, I didn't get to look at that graffiti, though.
I think I'm ready for thirds.
But you're only on your first.
My stomach plans ahead.
Your stomach
Let's
is stocked
talk later when
winter.
I'm not so high.
See you around, Max.
As do this, I
suppose. Okay, Supergirl. Let's go to my secret place. Don't even answer. We have places to go and people to do. Come on, before Mom starts some more shit. Let's bail.
It's Kate Marsh from Blackwell.
Big whoop. You don't call me once in 5 years and now you're all over some biatch you see every day at school? I see how you roll. So go ahead, chat up Kate Marsh from Blackwell. I've got other people to hang out with, too.
Gotta answer, I think.
Hey, Kate. What's up?
Please, don't let your best friend get in the way.
You okay? I promise, Kate. I won't forget. I swear. Just do your homework and don't stress. I really don't think we should go into this right now. I'll call you later, okay?
Thanks, Max. If you'd rather chill with Kate, please, go ahead.
You are ridiculous. I'm chilling with you, okay?
For now, let's rock.
I can't ignore her too much. She'll commit suicide.
Sucks that Chloe and Joyce got into an argument.
Guy watching me? Hey, a junkyard.
Is this a race?
Keep up.
How many times are you going to get pissed at me this week?
That depends on you and how well you do in this phase of the test. Welcome to American Rust, my home away from hell.
Raw and rough. It suits you.
Max, do you know how awesome this is? I get my best friend back, and she's also supersized.
We don't know for how long.
Exactly why it's time to have fun.
Are you kidding? After yesterday, I'm kind of over guns, Chloe. Freaks me out that you have one.
Don't you trust me?
Yes, but not that gun.
You have more power than an army. Don't be scared of my little toy. Besides, we need it for the test. Drink?
Yuck.
You are so cute. You haven't changed a bit. Okay, let's do this. Can you find 5 bottles while I prep the shooting range?
Beer and guns? Nice combo.
You can handle it. Now go find us 5 bottles, pretty please.
Sure, fine. Shirin, yeah, May.
Oh, gross. So disturbing to see old syringes on the ground. Hmm. I could use this board as a bridge. Doesn't look too heavy. All this rusted metal makes me feel serene. Am I morbid or just goth?
Don't know. Morbid?
This looks like a graffiti museum for Chloe and Rachel. I bet I can find out more about Rachel here. I don't want to intrude, but I was here. Now we're officially a trio. We just have to find Rachel. Ouch.
Fuck you, Yessie. What? Makeup case?
I can't see Chloe playing with makeup. That kind of hurts.
Why does it hurt?
Now, what's up with this weird secret relationship? Sounds like Rachel was confused about it, maybe even ashamed. I wish she named names. I better not show this to Chloe or she will be seriously hurt.
Vortex Club Snubs, I know you'll have a meltdown when I tell you and think he's gross. Or he's... let me guess. That dickhead probably has something to do with this. Bottle.
Hello, bottle number one.
Sis.
I want to die. Jeez. Who wrote this?
Rachel, maybe?
So Rachel did go to a Vortex Club party. This flyer is dated right before she disappeared.
Right.
They would have gone all the way to Los Angeles for a rave. Looks fun.
Rachel's better at darts than Chloe, apparently. Bottles? Oh, doll.
Aw, poor thing. They left you here all alone.
No, it's bottles, whatever you are. What's that?
This is the scariest thing here.
Is it? Washing machine.
I wonder how many generations of fashion went through that washing machine.
Oh, I got knocked over. Campfire.
I'm sure this is a popular party pit.
Another bottle.
Boom. Only 3 bottles left.
Ah! How far back did I go? Where's Warren went? Too late. It's about what? I didn't drown it, I didn't even water it. Maybe I should have watered it.
Nope, I don't want to go there.
You sure do. Trains come by pretty common there. Square up. There's another bottle, hooray.
3 down, 2 more to go. Talk about finding a bottle in a haystack.
All right.
I wonder if Chloe thinks about her father when she looks at all these smashed up cars.
Hmm. 2 more bottles, 2 more bottles.
Wow, sir. That looks exactly like the same dough from my tornado vision.
Great. Something bad is gonna happen then.
That dough is the perfect photo op.
I don't even see it. I'm super blind, apparently. Where is it? Where is it? There it is. Photo. I'm gonna assume it didn't even take the picture of it, because it's see-through, kind of. It's a stump. I don't always sit on it.
It's so quiet and primordial out here. I always feel like the forest is whispering to me. Like Arcadia Bay is trying to tell me something. I just have to figure out the message.
Hmm. Let's get up. 2 more bottles, let's find them. If I was a bottle, where would I be?
Where to find... No way! I totally remember going there when I was a kid. I loved the Hush Puppies. Now the sign is just Arcadia Bay junk.
Hmm. And I totally over... took her what she was gonna say there.
This was an old school punk shirt.
What else is hiding in this junkyard? A Hey, look through the washing machine, I'm pretty sure.
I wonder how many generations of fashion went through that washing machine.
A boat.
So sad to look at a grounded boat. I wonder who owned that and where they are now.
Unemployed, dead, who knows?
Look what we have here. A cute little bottle for the taking.
And things are gonna fall down on you.
Stupid bottle.
Alright, well, we'll get that later then.
Nope, I don't want to go there.
But why not? Alright, what else we got here? An old TV screen, or that monitors. Gun shells.
Those shells look fresh. Where to find bottles? Maybe in an old refrigerator.
Up here. Football.
The Bigfoots were here.
Wooden plank.
Way heavier than I thought. Ugh.
Yay, bottle.
One more bottle to go.
Let's go get the one on top of the refrigerator, I guess. Locate one now. Whoa. Act sorry to bother you, but asking for advice. I guess I shouldn't be doing anything but let enjoy. That is so not what I meant. I just want you to be careful. Sit on the chair, why not? What does that do?
Although this junkyard is a dive, I see why Chloe hangs here. She's a steampunk. It actually feels like Chloe and I are kids again. We're hiding out and plotting our future. Despite all the chaos and bullshit, I feel so giddy hanging out with her again. So happy. Like we've both gone back in time.
Right, let's get up. And out in his boot. Down we go. Alright, bottle on the fridge. How do I get it? Bring something out. Move.
Maybe I can use this to reach the bottle. Where to find bottles?
There.
Maybe in an old refrigerator.
I already got it. Thank you. Where are you putting this?
Now I can deliver this bottle booty to Captain Chloe.
Thanks, Max. Wait, one more for the road.
We're serious about this.
We're gonna shoot all these bottles without wasting a single bullet. Max, you have to help me aim.
What?
Show me the way, Max.
I need to see you shoot first.
Right to the right.
Show me the way, Max.
Aim a bit to the right.
Sir, yes, sir. Oh, yes! Did you see that shit, Max?
Duh.
What a waste of my powers.
Now for the second bottle. Now, Max, where do I aim?
You're on target. Pull the trigger.
Or not.
Now, Max, where do I aim?
Aim slightly above.
I'm gonna have a massive migraine.
Watch out, Nathan. Now that is fun. Let's pump up the volume and find me another target. I want to get creative here.
What?
Give me something to shoot, Max.
Let's shoot.
Hello, what should I do?
I bet you want to blow apart those old computer monitors.
Let's reboot them with a bullet. Old school. Lame.
Fine.
Give me something to shoot, Max.
Shoot the rim, I guess.
Let's take out this wheel rim on your left.
Taking out the wheel rim now?
Nice.
Ella, yes!
Nice shooting, Tech.
Now that's what I'm talking about.
Satisfied?
Like never. So I want one more uber cool trick shot.
How about using that junker for a target now?
Shoot.
Dude, I need a target before I shoot.
Shoot.
Well, Max?
Yes, Tech.
Let's see what happens when you shoot the gas tank.
Step back. Gas tank go boom. Boom! Car definitely down, but no bottle casualties.
All right, well, that's all you want? All right. Fire.
Dude, let's I need a target shoot. Before I shoot.
Windshield.
I want to see that windshield go down.
Watch out for flying glass. You guys better run for cover.
Yet the bottle remains.
Damn it. Let's try shooting.
Well, Max?
The bumper.
Put a real dent in that front bumper.
Goodbye, cruel bumper. Jesus, I shot myself! Ugh, I shot myself! Back up, back
Stupid
up!
Stupid gun. Hold on, Chloe.
Well, that was stupid.
What?
Shoot the tire.
How about
tire.
Aiming for the left tire?
Adios, spinning wheel of death.
Nice.
Uber cool. I cannot believe this is for reals. My best friend is a superhero. Now it's your turn to bust a cap.
And she's gonna have a massive brain headache.
Know.
Max, your nose. Damn.
I don't feel so super.
Max!
overused your power a little bit. Nothing too major.
You freaked me out there. Do you feel any better now?
A little. Thanks for helping me. Just give me a minute.
Too much action for Arcadia?
Maybe not enough. This is kind of fun. Scary and stupid, but fun.
Let me know when you feel okay.
God, this power really messes with my head. I'm glad I feel normal again.
You know.
I better go chat up Chloe.
Alright, let's look around again.
I wonder if Chloe thinks about her father when she looks at all these smashed up cars.
They knew I can look at? Probably not. I wonder if that deer came back.
This was an old school punk shirt.
Here it was. Not some, but rags. Alright, what are you looking at?
Look at her. Chloe can even chill out playing with a gun.
Okay. Looks like you're ready to lock and load.
I don't know about this.
Are you afraid of getting in trouble? Oh, boo-hoo, Max is afraid. I know you can handle this, and I'm here to guide you. Make me proud, sister.
Hey, and that guy's back. And Louise. Or is it Bonnie and Clyde?
Excuse us, Frank.
Oh, sorry, Chloe. Don't let me get in the way of your bonding. I heard the gunshots and the breaking glass. It's cute that you're playing with guns. Just like me at your age.
We're not anything alike, man.
We both need money. In fact, you need it so bad, you owe me a shitload, don't you, Chloe? Huh?
You'll get your money.
Don't they all say that? You know, even when they're broke and acting tough? What are you hiding there, girlie? Let me see.
Where did you get that bracelet?
A friend, and it's none of your goddamn business. You're my business now.
That's Rachel's bracelet. Why the fuck are you wearing her bracelet?
Calm yourself, all right? It was a gift.
No, it wasn't. You stole that shit. Give it to me right now, asshole.
You better step back before you regret it, girl. I mean it. You want me to cut you, bitch?
Please. Please step back.
You're kidding. Put that down.
No, let's not shoot because that'd be bad, I think.
Come on, girly. Shoot me. Ah, Christ. You're more like Abbott and Costello.
I should have shot.
Nice piece. I'll consider this interest on your loan. Thanks. You have until Friday to pay me, or I'll track you down with this interest. Have a good play, kids.
You really stood your ground.
I freaked. I don't like guns.
It'll be hard to keep Nathan off my ass. My step shit will have his other gun sealed in an electrified bunker by now.
Sorry, Chloe. I've never held a gun on a human being before. Not cool.
I know, Max. Really. I'm actually relieved it worked out this way instead. And there are more guns out there. Let's blow. My secret lair didn't feel secret today. At least Frank is gone. He He won't fuck with us again. He just wants his money.
Oh, man. Frank took Chloe's gun because of me.
Yeah, we don't need that gun.
Wowzer. Why did Frank have Rachel's bracelet? We need to talk about this. Chloe's waiting to go for a walk. We both need a timeout from here.
Leave the junkyard. Get run over by a train.
I can't believe you basically gave him my gun. Here you go, Frank.
You can't keep getting mad at me. Especially for stupid shit.
I'm not mad. It adds up in my mind as people letting me down. And I just liked having that gun, man.
Now you have me to protect you.
I'm just glad you were here.
Me too. I think. Chloe, why the hell are you hanging around scary losers like Frank? It's weird.
Let's take a break and I'll talk. Feels like a different world, huh? I wish we could stay forever.
Can we build another pirate fort and keep the world out?
We need a new secret hangout. At least Frank wouldn't find us. Are you okay, Max?
No.
Seriously, Chloe, this is scary. What if Frank tries to track us down?
I'm sorry, but Frank isn't as hardcore as he fronts. All he cares about is his cash, stash, and mangy dog.
Chloe, are you for reals? Frank just took your gun and threatened us. He's armed and clearly dangerous.
Max, I know. Crazy shit is the new normal for me. That's why I plan to leave Arcadia Bay without paying Frank off.
Now, tell me exactly what's going on between you and Frank. Does he have a last name?
Frank Bowers, he's just a dealer where I get my weed. The one in your joint, remember? Anyway, Frank and I kind of hung out.
Bad boy.
Is this your bad boy phase?
No, it's my trying to scrounge some quick cash so Rachel and I could get the hell out of here phase. Frank had quick cash, that's all.
That's it?
No, I want to know how Frank got Rachel's bracelet. What do you think?
My brain is fried.
I think we have to be careful and keep an eye on this guy. Without him eyeballing us, okay?
It's so weird talking to you about this insane crap. We haven't hung out this much since we were tweens, and it's like no time has passed. I wish Rachel was here to meet you.
Rachel and I.
Do you think that Rachel and I would have been friends?
You're not that different. She has a great eye for images and for art. Plus, she's a smartass like you. We would all be hella best friends forever.
I know she must be as cool as you are. I have no doubt we'll meet soon.
Railroad tracks always make me feel better. I have no idea why.
Kerouac knew. It's the romance of travel and movement. The sound of the train whistle at night.
Look at the beat poet here.
I'd rather be a good photographer.
You are. You just have to stop being afraid.
Where are you going?
Perfect.
Yay, tornado. Boot off. Take a boot off.
Get me out of here, Max!
Max, you can't just yank Chloe out like a superhero. Move!
Find something! Free me!
Alright.
Nope, I don't want to go there.
Come on, Max! Hurry!
I can't even move it an inch. Awesome, it's not locked. I better find the tool to cut those wires.
Besides. Crowbar.
The train's coming!
I know that.
I can definitely use this bad boy.
That's what we got out here. Working on it.
I can't budge it at all.
God damn it. And frick. All the way back. Now I'm gonna die. Take the wire cutters.
Now I can pull a total MacGyver.
That's what we got in here. Shit. Open the door, get out.
In and out, no problem.
I'm working on it to settle down.
Max!
I open and cut.
But which wire to cut?
The train's coming!
Cut the green one, sure.
Max!
Stupid light! No go! Shit!
Holy hell.
The train's coming!
But which wire to cut?
Red wire?
Now that's the right cable.
Get me out of here!
Yes! I did it!
That was close.
You okay? You saved me again. Crazy. Now we're totally bonded for life. Damn. That was close.
Aren't you glad I took you away to a nice, quiet, desolate spot?
It was cool to spend time in your lair, but I have to get back to school before my next class.
Since you're the mysterious superhero, I'll be your faithful chauffeur and companion.
My powers might not last, Chloe.
That's okay. We will. Forever.
Thanks for the ride, Chloe. Right on time for my art lesson.
Thanks for coming with me. Sorry to be so boring.
Nothing exciting ever happens to us, right?
Listen, your rewind power has to be connected to that snow yesterday. That might explain your tornado vision.
Explain what? Snow equals a ginormous twister that takes out Arcadia Bay? You're high.
Wake up, Max. You saved my life twice now. You altered the course of my destiny, yours, and whoever. Do you know about chaos theory?
Do you know?
What do you know about chaos theory, Miss I Hate Math?
5 years ago, asswipe. Some people change. And your situation is the perfect storm for quantum physics.
Why me? I'm just a geek girl in some small town.
A perfect example of strange attractors? Don't they teach you kids anything at Blackwell? We have a tornado, rewind power, and freak snow. Hello, Armageddon. So let's party with your power, Rockstar.
Like you said, Professor Price, a superhero needs a sidekick.
How can it be such a shitty week and yet one of the best of my life?
Because we're back in action again. Time before Mr. Jefferson's class, so I can do some wandering.
Sure, let's go talk to people.
Sir,
Hello, Max. Would you like to tell me what you wouldn't yesterday?
Fire alarm.
There was just a lot going on with the fire alarm and everything.
Yes, but you were distracted by something else.
I can't focus when I'm scared.
Please don't say that. There's nothing to be scared of at Blackwell Academy. Our head of security is overseeing a new era of campus safety.
Mr. Madsen already treats everybody here like they're under surveillance.
Wait. Do you see a pattern here, Max?
Probably not the same one you see.
You won't tell me the truth about yesterday, but you want to tell me the truth about Mr. Madsen. It sounds more like sour grapes. Excuse me now.
All right, then. Let's talk to David.
Excuse me, Mr. Madsen?
I know things got a little heated yesterday in Chloe's room. Was that really your reefer?
No. Should I say no? Sure, let's say no.
No, it belonged to a friend of mine. Are you gonna bust me now, Mr. Madsen?
Even I'm not that much of an asshole. And I am sorry about yesterday. I was wrong, but upset. Cannabis is not a big deal to you, but it has been to Chloe.
You're a combat veteran. She's no threat to you.
If I didn't care about her, I wouldn't care at all. When I was her age, I was out raising a lot more hell. She's better than that. All you kids are. So is Kate Marsh.
What about Kate?
What about Kate?
I shouldn't have said anything. You know about that video going around.
Is that why you hassled Kate yesterday? I took a photo of that moment for surveillance sake.
Soldier, you don't have the facts. You think I'm a hypocrite because I want cameras around here for the safety of the students?
That'll take more than surveillance cameras.
It will take more than Ms. Grant and her petition to find missing students.
Isn't that your responsibility as head of security? Unless you know something about Rachel Amber that nobody else does.
I don't want to fight with you anymore. I don't want to fight with anyone anymore. That's all, Max. You best not bother chatting me up now.
All right. What do you want, Warren?
I still have time. I could go see Warren playing mad scientist in the lab.
I kind of move now.
I saw Victoria and her friends shopping for the party.
That reminds me, I have to score some weed from Nathan. Yo, Maxwell Smart. Talk later, cool?
So you can't help me?
I'm trying, but you have to understand my position.
Kai, you don't understand mine. Nobody does. Nobody.
Hey.
Please, leave me alone.
Damn it. What else we got here? Oh, boy, now. Probably not gonna happen. Zach.
Hello, Zach.
Sup, Max? It's weird to not see you without your camera.
I'm always taking pictures with my eyes.
I bet. As long as you don't talk to everybody about all that shit with the sext and Victoria.
I won't. That's what Victoria wanted.
Yeah. I noticed she kind of set up her own drama. Even if it fucks her over. Weird.
She doesn't have to, though.
That's what I don't get at all. When she's hot, rich, talented, what more does she need? Anyway, see you at the game Friday, Max.
Where is the science lab?
Maybe you owed money to Frank, too.
Max, I have a meeting. Excuse me.
Go to your meeting.
Justin always looks stoned.
Sis.
Hey, Courtney. Ciao, Max. No photos, please. I have to come up with a guest list for a Vortex Club soiree. Really? Oh, like you care.
I do, I think.
I'm not anti-soiree. You seem anti-fashion, though. A Vortex Club party has a strict dress code. Do you even have a dress? Sorry, but nice try. Forget it, Max. No soiree for you. So
seriously. Hello, climate change.
All right, well.
Trevor surveys his domain.
Nuke. Let's go in the science lab, I guess.
Miss Grant is so cool and smart. She defines the word teacher.
Chemistry stuff. All right, what are you doing over here, Brooke?
Howdy, Brooke.
Hi, Max. Making your daily rounds?
Think, big brain, think.
Drone?
How is your drone?
Miss Grant busted me flying it over the parking lot. She's all jacked up about surveillance bullshit. Like I was spying on Warren's new car.
You already planted a GPS on him?
I borrowed the one he has on you.
I hate to hit and run, but...
Don't let me get in your way. So long.
A GPS on me?
Bring me the brain, Igor. Hey, Warren. Are you okay? You look thoughtful yet confused.
Maxwell Silverhammer. Perfect timing. I need help with this chemical experiment.
Asking me for help means you're screwed.
I have to add either a bit of potassium or sodium. It's up to you to decide, Dr. Max.
Potassium, sure, why not?
I'm not sure why you're letting me decide your fate, but... Go... Potassium.
Potassium it shall be. If this works, you get a free hug.
Not sure what you're even trying to do right now.
Weird science. Yes, I am a scientist. Fuck.
Bring me the brain, Igor.
Is that what he wanted? I don't know. That noise. That's raining, okay. Science art.
Da Vinci was a boss.
Hey. Oops, I don't want to do that. No, stop it.
Excuse me, Max. Can you come over here?
Sure.
You look worried. Is everything okay?
Sorry to bother you, Mr. Jefferson.
I'm only bothered when you avoid turning in photos. But you know this. So what can I do for you, Max?
Just between you and me, I'm worried about Kate Marsh.
You're not the only one. Do you have something you want to tell me?
I saw David Madsen harassing Kate yesterday. He was scaring her.
Mr. Madsen confuses fear with security. I'm sorry. Kate had to be a target of his paranoia. If you had proof, I could talk to Principal Wells.
Oh, yes. I have an actual photograph for once.
Let me see that photo after class. You're already thinking like a real photographer. And Max, I promise this matter is being discussed by the faculty. I assume you know about this viral video?
Is freaked out.
Kate is freaked out by all of this. She can't do homework while she's being tormented on a daily basis.
What if Kate brought this on herself? She means well, but maybe she doth protest too much. She seems like she's holding back the truth. Have you talked to her?
Yes, I have.
Yes, I talked to her on the phone today. She needs friends and support now. I just don't want Kate Marsh to become the next Rachel Amber.
Rachel Amber? What does she have to do with Kate?
With all her missing persons posters around, it's hard not to think of her.
Rachel was nothing like Kate. And Principal Wells said you had something on your mind you wouldn't tell him. You care to share?
Sure, why
not? I saw Nathan with a gun in the girls' bathroom yesterday. I was too scared to go to Principal Wells.
This is a serious accusation, Max.
So you don't believe me? I would never make something like this up.
I hope so, Max. But it's easy to point fingers. If Mr. Madsen claims you might be a pot dealer as he did, should I believe him?
Listen, should I...
Excuse me, Max. Hello? Yes? Hold on. I have to take this, so just go into class and I'll be there soon.
Maybe I shouldn't have told him.
Sure, okay. Listen, I do have a class I have to teach. I have to go. Okay, I'll do that.
Do what?
Oh, I know. That makes sense. Huh? Seriously, I have to hang up now.
All right, whatever.
Stella is smart to stay out of all the drama.
Dana, you are out of control.
Turn left. Right.
That's a great sketch of Dana. Daniel is the real deal.
And right, show me the love.
How do I look? Not now, Max. I'm contemplating shit.
I'll take a photo of you then. There's photos.
I'm kind of doing something now, Max.
That's nice.
What's up, Daniel?
Waiting to draw Dana after Hayden gets his paparazzi on.
No time to talk, Max. Posing in progress. Do you think Max will be pissed we're sitting at her desk?
Oh, I'm sure she'll.
No time to talk, Max. Art in progress.
Like I give a flying fuck.
Or she'll run to Mr. Jefferson, like he gives a shit.
Like anybody. Here comes the mysterious Max, disguised as a pixie hipster.
Like all the other precious twee artists here.
You really nailed me.
Meow! Bring out the claws. I love seeing chicks fight.
Right. Can I sit at my table now?
Max thought we were going to be buds. Fucking ha ha.
Assholes.
Whatever.
Okay, why is David taking photos of Kate? Now this is so wrong and weird.
I do it now.
What up, Max?
Hey, Warren.
I saw Kate earlier and her eyes were puffy from crying.
Kate has a lot on her plate.
I didn't know what to say, and she didn't tell me anything.
Okay, I know you love me, but if you're not in this class, beat it. Everybody else, please sit down. We have a lot to cover today, and so little time as usual. I see all the usual suspects here. Anybody seen Kate Marsh?
I think everybody has seen Kate Marsh by now.
I guess Kate will miss class now.
Sounds like you're giggling about a video.
I'm worried about her.
Maybe it involves a student?
It's cool that Mr. Jefferson published his own little book of photo tips.
I wonder how it would feel to have false images of yourself shot out all over the world for people to judge. No smartphones in class, Max. Put that away.
Dang it.
Usually, people need something to judge so they never take a good look at themselves. We can thank reality TV for some of that. In the end, we can only blame ourselves for participating.
He's pretty angry.
Speaking of participation, there are a few souls here who have... Yet to enter a photo in the contest. Like Max Caulfield, for example. Who I know can't wait to enter, right? I'm sure you read the syllabus like it was a Harry Potter book, so you must know today we're studying chiaroscuro. That beautiful word about the contrast between light and dark. The shadow play that gives photography such visual power. It's basic yin and yang. Black and white images are effective precisely because of their contrast. Although we don't technically see in mind.
Yo! Some crazy shit is going down in the girls' dorm!
Zachary, do not come into my class like that ever again. Listen, everybody remain seated. Dismissed.
This Kate's gonna kill herself.
It flipped out!
I didn't think she was that messed up.
Who is that?
Kate! Oh! She can't die. She can't.
I don't think you can do much to stop that.
Not now. I have to try something. I won't be able to rewind again and again.
And too much rewinding powers. Time is frozen.
Keep going, Max. You can do it.
Not sure what Enzo's to do, but whatever. Trying to save her. I know, nah. First time playing this chapter.
Yes.
Played the first chapter a while ago.
To do this by myself?
Did you come to get another Pulitzer shot like yesterday, Max?
I've been bullied too, Kate. And even when I got picked on, I stood up for myself.
I know you only stand up for yourself. That's why you let David get in my face, like everybody here.
That's not true. People want to help you.
Yeah, yes, probably will.
They want to help kill me. And they can get their wish.
Kate, your life is still yours, and we can get through this together. Let me help.
I'm glad to hear you worry about me. That makes me feel better.
You're my friend.
Of course I worry. You're my friend, Kate.
I did feel better talking to you on the phone. I always feel like you really listen.
Kate, please trust me. Come stand by me, okay? I can help you now. I know I can. This morning, I erased the web link to the video. It was written on the shower room mirror.
That's your story now. How can I trust you? What about this morning when I needed help? You told me to do nothing.
Gathering proof.
Kate, I'm gathering proof that Nathan Prescott drugged you. And you're not the only victim. So you have to help me take Nathan down.
Nathan Prescott? That makes sense. He's a scumbag. You have proof now?
Soon, then straight to the police. Think of it like we're cleansing Blackwell.
You do have my back, Max. That's the first time I've felt hopeful in a week.
Good. We all need to have each other's backs. So, I want you to come with me now. Please. You don't have to do this.
Max, I'm in a nightmare and I can't wake up. Unless I put myself to sleep. Then everybody at Blackwell can post pics of my body. I'm horny on the internet forever. No wonder they call it a web. Nothing can ever get out. Like my video. I wish I could go back in time and erase everything.
Oh, forget there are a billion videos. Sure.
Kate, there are billions of videos out there. Yours will fade away like white noise.
Oh, God, please, Max. You haven't seen the looks I get. Or the laugh.
I understand, truly. I get bullied, too. But this is a blip.
Yep, my life is a blip. Blackwell taught me I'm worthless. I'll prove it right now.
No!
Oh, crap. And I failed at saving her, I guess. Oops.
I know this isn't pleasant for any of us, but we have to go over what happened before Miss Marsh, before she did what she did. Officer Barry will be taking notes for the official police inquiry. I'm sure you'll give him your full cooperation. Such a tragedy. But there must be a reason for everything. We need to find out why Kate Marsh would be driven to such desperate action. As principal of Blackwell Academy, I take my duty seriously. I take the well-being of every student more seriously. What happened today should never happen in a hall of wisdom and knowledge. Mr. Madsen, as our head of security here, those roof doors should always be locked. That's just standard operating procedure. They were not, and that is indeed your responsibility.
Great. Mr. Jefferson, blamed for us.
I know you can't be expected to know what your students are going through, but Kate has assisted you in class, so you should have known something was amiss. Mr. Prescott, since you are responsible for the Vortex Club parties, and since Miss Marsh did attend your last party, you'll have to answer some more questions. Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the roof with Kate Marsh? Did she tell you her plan? Or anything at all? Please, tell us everything.
Sure.
All I know is that Kate was at a party and Nathan dosed her. She got wasted and kissed some boys on a viral video without a clue.
I dosed her? Without a clue. Have you seen the video? Whatever. Kate was loaded and playing the field.
You told Kate you took her to the emergency room.
I said I was going to take her to the ER. She sobered up eventually.
Bullshit. Something happened to her and you know it. How about we talk about you waving a gun in the girl's bathroom?
That's total slander. I could sue you and this school so fast. I already have a personal lawyer.
Wait, Max. You told me that nothing happened yesterday. Are you just making things up? How can I trust you?
You can't. She's smoking and selling dope, not saving lives.
No, I'm not. And that has nothing to do with Kate Marsh.
I'll have to investigate to see if this accusation is true. Therefore,
it's probably
Max,
got me killed now.
I'm obliged to contact your parents and suspend you for a few days.
Excuse me. I think Max and Nathan need a break before we grill them further. A friend and fellow student is dead. And they don't need this forum right now.
Yes, I'm kind of devastated right now. I'd like to be with my family.
All right, Miss Caulfield, please sign here to confirm what you've told us. I'll continue this investigation from there.
My head is killing me, but I think I can use my power again.
Sure, let's do that.
Oh,
Shouldn't do that, but whatever.
Miss Caulfield, why exactly were you on the route with Kate Marsh? Did she tell you her plan? Or anything at all? Please, tell us everything.
David Bowie.